It's important when we talk automation that we get back to basics. What are we automating and why are we automating it?
I've been in the IT infrastructure automation space for more than a decade. For me, as I think about what's exciting moving forward, it's really that generative AI is going to transform the way we think about IT operations and development, as well as application security.
AI and automation is not just limited to data analytics or chat interface anymore. I think AI and automation will become sort of the core layer for the IT operation.
With the rise of generative AI, some predict as many as 1 billion new applications will be created. When you think about managing 1 billion applications, what becomes very clear is there's no way to solve this problem without heavily automating it. So when I think about the opportunities, it's not only to invest in higher levels of automation, but it's really enabling that automation to be agentic itself. And that is what's going to power that next generation of 1 billion applications to be done at scale, efficiently, and securely.
When you start thinking about automation, you've got to think about highest value, lowest effort, and highest priority. You've got to put these business lenses in place first, and then you've got to go after it in terms of the willingness for us to automate an entire process.
As the business leaders are actually looking to bring AI into their ecosystem, I think it becomes very difficult for the IT organization to sort of support the ever-changing technology as well as the business need. The focus for the IT should not be onto the perfection. I think they should more focus on the momentum.
One of the biggest security challenges when we talk about AI is really around identity governance. How do you govern both the identity of the user as well as the identity of the various agents who are making data requests on behalf of an end user? If you don't solve those identity and governance challenges correctly, you can often end up in a situation where users have inappropriate levels of access to endpoint systems and data that they shouldn't because the AIs themselves have elevated levels of capability.
IBM is a trusted partner for PepsiCo because they've done large programs, small programs with us for a long time. This is also now a forward-thinking thought partner. A team that understands PepsiCo, a team that understands speed is important.
My partnership with IBM is very much focused today around the IT automation, so we can see how each department and divisions are spending their cloud spend. Prior to bringing all these costs together, the cloud cost was looked at more from a understanding just the billing and summarizing that in some sort of a format which finance can understand and the bills are paid. Nobody was understanding where the cost was being spent, how it was being spent, where are the problems are. Once we started our journey with Aptio, finance can understand where the costs are going, engineering can understand where the waste are in the system, even the business leader can then plan better.
I think the emergence of generative AI is bringing incredible new abilities for us to think about agentic automation, all the way from the infrastructure layer through to the automation and insights layers as well. And I think that's going to have a profound impact not only in developer productivity, but as well as operators, as well as InfoSec, and all of the groups that really support the underlying infrastructure that run our applications. So I'm super excited to see what this next era of infrastructure automation will look like.